Just like the transfer of traditional currencies from wallet to wallet, cryptocurrencies are virtually transferred between users worldwide, only in a highly decentralized system without the control of any government, the most popular of which is the Bitcoin. Paxful, a global Bitcoin trading platform, reports that Nigeria now has the second largest Bitcoin trading volume after the United States. Little wonder why a lot of people are currently displeased with the Central Bank of Nigeria when it issued a reminder to banks and other financial institutions prohibiting dealings in cryptocurrencies. This young investor is among many others who are not happy with the directive.
To tell you the truth, that ban of a thing has really, really affected my work, my kind of work, because I'm an online person that most times I buy things online, and these are the things I use, cryptocurrency, sometimes Naira and every other thing. Now I have to start looking for other ways to pay the persons I buy things from, to pay the people I buy materials that I use online to work and all those kind of things, because most times I use Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies to pay them. I use that one to pay them, but now I can't.
In a statement issued by the Apex Bank, the use of cryptocurrencies in Nigeria contravenes the provisions of the CBN Act of 2007, which mandates the Apex Bank to be the sole issuer of legal tender currency in Nigeria. CBN also justified its decision on the need to protect the financial system from the risk involved in cryptocurrencies, such as its speculative nature, a high price instability, unregulated and untraceable transfer of funds between users, which the government believes are increasingly used to fund criminal activities. This financial expert is of the view that, although the concerns of the government are genuine, however, the government can put certain regulations in place to checkmate criminal activities.
Because you could put a stopgap in between a free market that nobody controls and make it a bit regulated in our own context. Yes, people can do some disclosure on what the transaction is meant for, and the receiving bank should be able to do declaration on suspicious transactions. So that the same rule of engagement that is involved in remittance, international remittance, can be applicable. That will be my solution to the problem, not I tried to stop it.
He explains that the plight of the youth should have been considered before an outright ban.
If today you create your own blockchain technology that is managing the government services, that is managing the banking transaction in this country, and you take some of these guys that are experts in cryptocurrency to say, oh guys, stop that. We have created a blockchain technology that is going to be running this country on all our financials. Come and manage it for us. You will see a lot of them dropping in and come and take legal businesses. But what alternatives are you giving them?
Some analysts are of the view that the government should be able to consider the merits and the demerits of cryptocurrencies. In Abuja, Toiba Anifowose, NTA News.